Well, Kellaya, here we are again. Why do you feel the need to do this every time?
I know that it's different for you, Jontana. You face death differently to any of us.
This is true. As historian, I suppose I feel a greater appreciation for the life that we have been given.
Wish I could see things the way that you do.
One day, you will.
Perhaps. I think this has gone on long enough now. You do like to draw it out, don't you?
Indeed I do. Perhaps you are right. I've waited long enough.
Then I shall leave you to it and wait outside.
Thank you, Claire.
Now, no more waiting. It's time for you to die.
Saying is that if you're going to swim naked in the pool, then please give me a bit of warning first.
How was I supposed to know you were even in there? It's not like you put up a sign or anything.
I shouldn't have to. It's common courtesy to check before just jumping in.
Well, you should have just looked somewhere else.
You dove straight over me. I saw a lot more than I ever wanted to, thank you very much.
Oh, are you two still going on about this?
Yes, we are. When I went for a relaxing swim, the last thing I expected was to be greeted by Serena's...
I think perhaps you should end that sentence there.
Look, I know where you're from, people aren't as open about the body, but it really was just an honest mistake.
Well, maybe people in your century don't mind it, but I do.
Then I apologise. It won't happen again.
Good.
Daisy!
Apology accepted.
There, that's better. Now... would you like to know about this place or not?
Of course. I'm sorry.
Right. Well, first of all, may I direct your attention to the sky?
Whoa. That's beautiful. What is it?
This planet is one of the most unique in the universe. It was discovered by my people a long time ago. Its star went supernova, but Omega, a solar engineer and one of the founders of Time Lord science, preserved it in a pocket of time at the moment of collapse.
And that's what we're looking at?
Correct. Omega used the star to conduct experiments that would later reveal the secrets of time travel that we use today. However, radiation from the star still manages to escape now and then, and so the planet was marked as off-limits.
Radiation?
Off-limits?
Oh, don't worry. We're perfectly safe. Exposure is only harmful if you were to remain here for a long time, and no one would be that foolish.
Oh. So, what's the planet called?
It was named Patience, a tribute to Omega's wife.
Oh, that's so sweet.
Yes, perhaps he was once.
Sorry?
Nothing. So, shall we have a little look around?
Why not?
Well, I could maybe think of one reason.
Serena? Ah, I see.
Do not try anything, or I will cut her throat.
Is that so? Well, I've only got one thing to say to you.
And what is that?
Take me to your leader.
Triskor, What is this?
I found them just over the ridge. They were standing by a big blue box.
Blue box?
Yes, that's my ship.
Silence! You will speak only when permitted.
There will be no need for that, Triskor. You must excuse my protector. He can be a bit, well...
Protective?
Precisely. Who are you?
Well, my two friends here are Daisy and Serena, and I am the Doctor.
Doctor? How did you get here?
In my ship. It's called the TARDIS.
I knew it! I could smell Time Lord on him the moment I saw him.
Triskor, that's enough.
Is there some sort of a problem?
Why are you here? Who sent you?
Nobody sent me. We're just exploring.
Then you can turn around, get back into your TARDIS and explore somewhere else.
Doctor, I thought you said that no one could be here.
Ah, quite right. How is it that you're here?
No questions. Just leave and do not return.
Perhaps we should do as they say, Doctor.
It's too late to let them go. They have already seen our settlement.
What are you suggesting, Triskor? That we keep them here?
Not at all. I think we should kill them.
Now hold on a minute. That's a bit drastic, isn't it?
Enough! We should kill them now.
No, that is not our way.
Jontana, you are looking much better.
You mean health-wise or looks?
Both.
Kellaya, we can't let them live. We swore...
We swore that we would never fall as low as those who sent us here. If we kill them, we not only go back on that promise, but I guarantee that it will bring far more attention than if we just let them go.
You are right, Jontana. We shall not kill them.
But...
Excuse me! Would somebody mind telling us what is going on here?
If I may.
Proceed.
You see, Doctor, your name is more than familiar to us. We have heard about you many times back on our home world.
And where is your home world?
Why, Gallifrey, of course.
What?
It is true. Centuries ago, we were once part of the Shabogan tribes.
Shabogans?
Yes. You see, there were two major distinctions on Gallifrey. The high-born Gallifreyans would be allowed to enter the Academy to become Time Lords, while those born outside in the Wastes were left to fend for themselves.
That's monstrous.
Not exactly Gallifrey's finest hour.
But there was worse to come. The Time War, for example.
What happened to you?
We began to grow weary of the Time Lords holding things from us. A society that had so much and yet wouldn't look after their own because of a sense of nobility. So we began to orchestrate raids on the capital. We would steal food, supplies, anything to aid our way of life. After a while, we began to steal technology as well. One day, I found myself in the regeneration chambers. I saw a chance, and I took it. I stole the data relevant to unlocking the gene that allows Time Lords to regenerate. It was a long process, but eventually I discovered a way to give us the ability, without the limitation of only 12 regenerations.
You did... what?
Think of it, Doctor. An endless regeneration cycle. To forever be able to live on and be young. This truly is the age of youth.
But you can't do that! The 12 regeneration limit is there for a reason.
And tell me, Doctor, how many regenerations have you had?
That's beyond the point. The mind isn't capable of dealing with more than 12. Just look at what it did to the Master.
And yet you seem perfectly all right.
Not sure I'd agree with that.
I will admit there are exceptions, but how many is too many? 30? 40? 100? How long before it drives you insane?
That is why the High Council banished us here. They could have removed our ability, or even killed us, but they decided that our punishment should be more severe.
We were banished here and have been living out our lives for many regenerations. We have always expected someone to come looking for us someday, either to finish us off or perhaps even to welcome us back. But we have built a life here and we do not wish to have it taken away.
We would never do such a thing. Right, Doctor?
So, you just keep on regenerating for all of time. What do you expect to happen when the universe just passes you by and you no longer have anything left? How do you propose to keep on living then?
Triskor, take the women away and lock them up.
Oh, what?
Now, Triskor.
Come on, Daisy. We will be back with the Doctor soon. Right, Doctor?
Of course.
Now that we are able to talk more freely, I would ask something of you, Doctor.
I'm not taking you back to Gallifrey.
We do not wish to return there.
Then what?
You were right, Doctor. We have all regenerated more than 1,000 times, some even higher than that. We cannot go on any longer.
So find a way to make it stop.
We have tried, but we have not been successful.
And what does this have to do with me?
We want you to help us die.
No.
Doctor, please.
No, I have caused the death of far too many. Shobigans, Gallifreyans, and the Time Lords alike. I will not be the cause of any more.
Kellaya, if I may be excused.
Of course. So you would condemn us, Doctor?
Who am I to go against the will of the Council?
Doctor, take a walk with me.
Stay in here. If you try to leave, you should know. There's a guard on the door, and I've told him to shoot you if you try anything. Now stay quiet.
Ugh, this is just typical.
What do you mean?
You must have noticed. Whenever things get interesting, it's always the Doctor that gets in on the action while we get placed in a cell.
That's not true, and you know it's not.
It seems that way to me.
We just need to sit this out and wait for the Doctor.
Oh, what do you know? You're only a kid. What are you, 12?
I'm older than you think.
How much older?
A lot.
I suppose you're going to say that anti-aging techniques are vastly superior in your time.
Something like that. Look, I'm trying my best to get along with you, Daisy, but you seem determined to fight me. Why?
You know why.
I'm not here to take your place, and I never have been.
Then why did he leave me for over a year?
You know the answer to that.
Do you have any idea what it was like? Waking up every morning and hoping I would hear that groaning sound of the TARDIS, and feeling my heart break a little bit more every time that I didn't.
It was difficult on the Doctor, too.
How so?
He never said anything to me, but I could tell that he felt somewhat empty. He'd lost you. He had lost his TARDIS, but most of all, he had lost his freedom. We were travelling for a whole year in my ship, and unlike the TARDIS, it is not bigger on the inside. He put together a laboratory in his quarters, and he would sit there for hours, sometimes days. One day I went in there to check on him, and he was nowhere to be seen.
Where had he gone?
He'd created a force field around himself, one that would even render him invisible. He had become so paranoid that he would isolate himself from everything.
Why?
Because he couldn't face the reality that he was letting you down. Or worse, that you could be dead. The Doctor cares about his friends, Daisy. Sometimes it may seem like he doesn't, but just remember, he has two hearts. That means he cares twice as much.
I'd never thought of it that way.
He may have been focused on stopping the war, but his main aim was always to get back to you.
Serena.
Yes?
I'm glad you were there for him. I'm sorry for the way I've been behaving.
I'm sorry too.
Maybe, in time, we could be friends too.
I'd like that.
Me too.
Excuse me. Am I intruding?
Oh, in our cell? No, not at all.
I am sorry that you have been placed in here. I would, however, speak with your friend.
Me? What about?
Come with me, and I will tell you.
No, she's staying here.
It's all right, Daisy. I'll go.
Right this way, my dear.
Be careful.
I will.
Look at all that we have built, Doctor. We are proud of our home.
So why the wish to leave it all behind?
Look closer. Do you notice anything?
Should I?
Try seeing what is not there.
I see plenty. The buildings, the tools, the people. Wait. That's it. I see plenty of people, but all adults. Where are your children?
We have no children. What you see here are the original settlers.
What happened?
The star. Its radiation has rendered us unable to conceive life. That is why we wish to die. Who are we doing this for if there will be no future generations? We have built all of this for ourselves, but we have grown tired of living, yet we are unable to die.
Well, there is a way to stop the regeneration process. And all you do is...
Are you seriously suggesting that we murder each other at the point of regeneration?
Yes, of course. I see what you mean.
There is only one way to stop this, and that is to remove our ability to regenerate. Please, Doctor. I am not asking you to kill us, only to help us. And from what I've heard, the Doctor does just that and has always been the first one to go against the will of the Council. Or am I wrong?
No, you're absolutely right.
So I ask again, will you help us?
So, you see the problem?
Yes, I do, but I don't really see why I should be able to help you.
No.
You need the Doctor.
They do not know, do they?
Know what?
What you are.
I don't know what you mean.
Yes, you do. You are the key. I can see it. Don't ask me how. I just do. Without the Doctor's help, your knowledge could be invaluable.
If I help you, will you keep my secret?
Of course.
Then I guess I have no choice.
You wait a whole year to be rescued, only to find yourself locked up in a small hut on a planet that's been blasted by radiation from a collapsed star that's frozen in time. Oh, I have missed this.
I see your friend has gone to help Jontana.
Yeah, so?
Which leaves you all alone in here.
Your point being?
Well, without anyone to keep you company, it would be very easy to become bored and attempt an escape.
You needn't worry, I'm not going to do that.
No, but nobody else will know that, will they?
What do you mean?
Perhaps you tried to escape and I had no choice.
No! Help!
Do not struggle. You will only make it worse. The girl is escaping! You two, come with me! We will hunt her down.
I am glad that you have decided to help, Doctor.
Yes, well, there's no guarantee that I will be able to solve your little problem.
Oh, I have confidence in you, Doctor.
Oh, I'm glad someone does.
Doctor, come quick. Your friend has escaped and Triskor has gone after her.
What?
He's just going to bring her back, though, right?
I fear not. He means to kill her, Doctor.
We're going after them. Serena, stay here and keep working.
Oh, come on, Daisy. You just need to make it back to the TARDIS.
This way. She's gone this way. Hurry!
Oh, I really wish I had my stun gun right now.
Where do you think she's heading?
There's only one place she can be going. Come on.
Come on, Daisy. Almost there. Oh, no.
We have you now, girl. Grab her!
No, please don't.
Bring her to me. I'm going to enjoy this.
No!
Stop!
This girl attacked me and escaped. She must die.
First of all, she's not a girl. She's a woman. And secondly, I doubt an unarmed prisoner in a guarded room posed any threat to you at all. Then again, you're clearly a coward.
How dare you?
That's enough. Release her at once.
But...
at once.
Let her go.
Doctor.
It's all right, Daisy. You're safe now.
I expect this kind of shameful behaviour from you, Triskor. But you two should know better. If you wish to avoid his punishment, then you will do exactly as I say. Is that understood?
Yes, Kellaya.
Punishment?
You will take Triskor back to the settlement and place him under guard.
Right away. Move.
No. You can't do this.
I'm sorry that this happened.
It's okay. I'm all right.
We should return to the settlement.
This is outrageous. She can't do this.
She is our leader. She can do as she pleases. Now, remain silent.
I left Serena and Jontana working on the problem. Hopefully, they have found something.
Doctor, can I ask you something?
Of course.
Serena told me about your need to isolate yourself.
I didn't realise you two were speaking to each other in a civilised way.
If there's ever anything you want to talk about, then I'm always here.
What would I want to talk about?
I don't know. I just want to make sure that you're okay.
I'm always okay.
Doctor, please speak to me. I'm your friend.
I know. It's just that this last year I've had a lot of time to think. Mainly about the person I was before I met you. The things that I did. They've just been weighing down on me pretty heavily.
Whatever you did in the past doesn't define who you are now. You're the Doctor. And the Doctor is a good man.
Thank you, Daisy. I needed to hear that. Now, shall we go in?
Doctor, come and take a look.
What have you found?
Not me. Your young friend here.
Serena hard at work, as always.
I believe I've managed to trace the problem, but I can't seem to find a way to correct the gene sequence.
Let me see. Ah, yes, I see it.
You see the problem?
Hush a moment.
This is all very exciting.
I said hush! Aha!
Doctor?
That's it! You've done a remarkable job, Serena, but not being a Time Lord means you weren't able to spot the correct sequence.
Are you saying that?
Yes, I can do it, but I'll need to administer the solution directly. Serena, fetch me the box of syringes from the TARDIS.
On my way.
Has everyone now received the solution?
Jontana here is the last one. Now, this won't hurt a bit.
Ow!
Sorry, I lied.
Thank you, Doctor.
Sadly, there's no way to know if it's worked until one of you is ready to die.
One of us is ready to die, Doctor.
Oh, good.
Bring him in.
Let go of me!
Triskor?
Yes, Doctor. I told him that he would be punished.
Now hold on a moment. This is going too far. You're talking about execution.
Did not the Time Lords once punish you with both execution and banishment?
Yes, but that was different. I regenerated.
And so may he, if you have failed.
Look, if you're doing this purely because of what he did to me, then there is no need whatsoever.
This is not the first instance of traitorous behaviour from him.
But this isn't the way to deal with it.
Exactly. Stop this now, before it goes too far.
It is already too late for that.
No, I won't let you.
Hold them.
Hey, let go!
Get off me!
Kellaya, please, please don't do this.
Triskor, as punishment for your crimes, you face your final death. But do not fear, for your end will be the beginning of our end. Our reward shall be to die a noble and peaceful death. Prepare yourself.
I am at peace with myself, but you will suffer for this. I swear it.
Kellaya, this is your last chance. Please just put the knife...
No!
It is done.
Look, there is no sign. No regeneration. The Doctor did it.
No. You're the ones who did this. I knew I should have stuck to my instincts. We should have just turned and walked away when we had the chance.
Well, now that you have no purpose here, I think that's exactly what you should do. Release them.
So, you just use us for what you need and then send us on our way? When we arrived here, I saw the hatred that you have for the Time Lords. You said that you swore to never stoop to their level. Well, now you've shown me that you are more like them than you give yourselves credit for. You disgust me.
Doctor, I suggest you leave while the offer is still available.
Oh, don't worry, we're going. And on the way out, I'll leave a little sign that says, Stay clear.
Farewell, Doctor.
Come on, you two.
Thank you for all your help.
Get bent. This really was an awful day. Do you want us to leave you alone, Doctor?
You see, this is the very reason that I hate dealing with my own people. This happens every time.
Doctor, please calm down.
I'm sorry. I just need some time. If anybody wants me, I'll be in the library.
He'll be okay.
I know.
I'll keep an eye on the controls. Make sure we don't wander too close to any wormholes.
Serena, do you know anything about the Doctor's family?
I've studied his life pretty closely. The only mention of family I've come across is his granddaughter, Susan.
Granddaughter?
Yes. Why?
It's just that someone mentioned the name Jenny to me. I asked him about her and he said that she was his daughter. And that she died.
That's very possible. He has lived for thousands of years.
I know, it's just... it's strange to think of him having a family. That probably sounds terrible.
No, I understand what you mean. The thing you have to remember about the Doctor is that even though he makes out to be the loneliest man in the universe, he does in fact have the largest family there is.
He does?
Yes. We're his family. Us and those of us who have travelled with him in the past. He carries us with him at all times. Though someone may be gone from your life, they are never truly gone from your heart.
Kellaya, someone else has arrived.
Who are you?
Oh dear, not exactly a life of luxury, is it?
Identify yourself.
Oh come now, Kellaya. You know who I am.
What do you want, Castellan?
I don't believe I was speaking to you.
Just answer the question. Why are you here, and why have you brought the Chancellery Guard with you?
Oh, they aren't the Chancellery Guard. They're just a select few who follow me and my vision.
What are you talking about?
You see, myself and my followers are on a very important mission to erase the mistakes of the past. Starting with you. Kill them. Kill every last one of them.
Ha 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 ha.